Now, did you speak to any of the Dutertes before you made the decision? I'm curious, because you were and you are in speaking terms with Vice President Duterte. Did you reach out? Did you speak to them or not at all?
Well, after his term pagkapangulo, there were two reunions that happened sa mga former members, di ba? Of the cabinet and appointees. So there were two reunions after that. But after the second reunion, I don't know kung nagkaroon ng mga meetings after or reunions after that, but hindi na ako kasama doon sa any meetings or reunions. So there was really no chance really to speak or to talk.
Okay.
But I know that, you know, itong pagtakbo naman po natin, I know that he would respect this decision to give Davao choice.
Now, you said there was a clamor of the people, but is it right to say you are running as an independent, but is the administration supporting you, Karlo?
I'm running as an independent. Tama yung sinabi ko. Sama sinabi mo, I'm independent candidate and I'm an independent candidate because I don't want any partisan politics involved here. And really, what we're really saying is I'm an independent candidate and I'm open to anyone from Davao City who wants to join, who wants to support, who wants to help, who believes that it's a time for change, that who believes in chance, who believes in choice, who believes in change, who believes in improving Davao City, who believes in what we stand for and what we're trying to do, at the very least, we're open. So at least kung independent tayo, then kumbaga we're saying we're open. And then pagdating naman ng panahon, diba, if we're blessed enough to sit, then that will still be the same message. We're open to asking from help from anyone. Kasi based dun sa JICA report, you need 20 billion for the short term, you need 60 billion for the long term, and Davao City has many other issues and concerns that they have to address. So we really need the help of anyone who can help, no? Some from the national government who can help us fix the flooding problem, and even from JICA, from international development bodies, they're all welcome to help us solve the issues and problems here in Davao. So from an independent candidate who's saying, come on, let's come together and let's help each other here. Kung tayo man ay blessed enough to sit, then that would still be the same sort of message that we'll be providing to everybody. Come and help Davao City fix our concerns and our problems together.
Okay. Now, ano ang lamang ng isang Karlo Nograles sa isang Rodrigo Duterte? Let's talk about that. He was former president. He was mayor of Davao for more than 20 years, right? So, eto ka, this is your first try as a mayor of a city that essentially has been a stronghold of this same man. Right? So this same man is known for changing Davao, pero anong lamang ngayon? Ngayong 2025, bakit si Karlo Nograles, anong lamang mo? One is, I would say, age. Is age a factor?
I don't know if age is a factor, maybe, but I see some of the improvements that we can do in Davao City. For instance, yung mga business permits namin sa Davao City, building permits, and all of the permits that go through City Hall, pwede naman natin pabilisin yan, di ba? If you look at the other cities, they're already on e-governance. They're already on digital governance.
Naiwan ang Davao?
We're still not there. Wala pa tayo dun sa online payment. You apply for your business permits online. You get it fast. You get it quick. You can pay it online. These things are already being done in other cities, in more progressive cities. And Davao is supposed to be the queen city of the South. We're supposed to be the premier city of Mindanao. But the business permits and all of the permits can already go digital, di ba? Can already go e-governance online. Yun na po yung ginagawa ng iba. But I don't know why we're not doing it in Davao City. Over and above that, yung ID card, e-cards na yan sa ibang cities para mas mabilis ang mga pagbibigay ng serbisyo sa ating mga sa mga kababayan, sa mga constituents ng different cities. But in Davao, Wala pang ganun, diba? Some cities are giving more benefits to senior citizens maliban sa cake every birthday. They also give over and above what the SWD is giving. They're giving also free medical checkups, free laboratory, free lahat na pwedeng ibigay sa mga senior citizens. But in Davao, it's still not like that.
Wala ganun sa Davao.
I don't know why. Oh. It's not as if Davao doesn't have the money for it. It does. And I don't understand bakit hindi natin kayang i-maximize ang lahat yan for the benefit of our people in Davao City.
Oh. So what is it, Karlo? Is it a problem of the performance of the Dutertes in the last few years, frankly? Or is it you're offering essentially modernization for Davao, like a modern point of view or a different way to manage and administer?
I don't want to take anything away from Davao. I don't want to take anything, all of the accomplishment that has brought Davao here to this point. But I believe that we can do things faster. We can improve on things faster. There are better ways of doing things, especially with technology now. Better utilization of technology for more efficient governance and services for our people. These are things that have to be seriously considered kasi hindi naman pwedeng the same usual thing all over again. And I think that's what we hope to bring to Davao City, especially since ayaw rin naman po natin na mapag-iwanan din tayo ng ibang mga syudad na we don't have to look so far. We have to look lang at our neighbors in Luzon, in NCR, and in Visayas, and they're already doing that. And I don't want Davao to be left behind. We can also do that because we have the means, the capacity, and the money to do all those things and even better, diba? We should be the example for Mindanao. We should set the bar high for Mindanao. And for the rest of the country, I think Davao can do that.
Okay. Now, are the Davaoenos, you know, it takes courage for you to do this, actually, to run against former President Rodrigo Duterte. But are the Davaoenos courageous enough too? Are they feared, both loved and feared in Davao? So paano mo lalabanan yun, yung takot sa mga Duterte?
Actually, Karen, itong pagpasok ko dito is a big step forward already for Davao. It's a big leap. Sabi ko nga, pagpasok ko dito, at least my choice na. So it now becomes 50-50. Right? It's a 50-50 choice. Choice A, choice B, it's 50-50 now. And it's really up to the Davaoenos to make that choice. At we have 6 months to go. Give me time to explain to you what we want to do. And at the end of this process, pagdating sa election, it's really up to you. Nasa inyo naman yan eh. Nasa kamay ninyo. But at least I gave you guys a chance.
Oo. Nag-iikot ka na. I'm sure nag-iikot ka na ngayon, no? Oh, yeah. Nag-iikot ka na. May mga balwarte ka na bang nakikita, Karlo?
Sorry,
Mari. May mga balwarte ka na bang nakikita? Meron na bang mga politiko, mga kababayan mo na kapag kinakausap mo, nakikita mo nagbubukas ang isipan nila?
After I filed, I was surprised. Frankly, I was surprised. I did not expect a lot of messages that came my way. I thought I was going for this. The message really is just to give Davao choice, a chance. But overwhelming yung ano, narinig na at nakukuha naming mga messages.
Okay. Now, ang iba kasi, ang mga malalakas na pamilya, naglalagay lang ng kalaban for the sake na may kalaban. Are you really here to win this, Karlo?
Of course, but it's up to the people. It's really up to... Like I said in my speech, as I always have, as I always will, I will fight hard to serve. I will give it my best. I've always done that. Wherever God puts me, I will always give it my best.
Okay. Now, I just want to ask you this. You're 48 years old. Am I correct? That's what it says here?
Yeah.
You're 48, right? You're 48. And former President Duterte, well, he said he's 73, but sources say he's 79, right? So do you see this as a factor too, right? Nakikita mo bang malaking kaibahan yun sa pagboto? Ang bumoto, I mean, it is an issue in the presidential race in the US. Right now, age is a factor too. In terms of energy, dynamism, nakikita mo ba na malaking bagay ito that you are 48 at ang dating pangulo, kumbaga naging pangulo na, babalik pa, is in his late 70s?
I think at the end of the day, it's for the people to factor things in. It's a lot of things to, it's a lot of factors to consider. Perhaps it might be a factor to some, perhaps it's not. So pagde-decide ng tao, you really don't know eh. You know, it's people have their own ways of weighing things. But at least nandiyan na tayo sa exercise na yan, right? Kesa sa you're not weighing anything kasi there's nothing to weigh kasi there's no one to choose, there's nothing, there are no choices, 'di ba? At least we're in this exercise, right? Nandito na tayo and then people are now talking and considering and they're weighing opinions and it's nice to see people discussing now about things that are happening in Davao, not just in Davao, but people outside of Davao already talking about this. Mm. But more so dito sa Davao, it's nice to see families and friends come together and start discussing politics and weighing their options and writing down and verbalizing mga pros and cons ng mga candidates. Mm. That's what elections are all about. That's why we have elections. So people can talk about these things and really consider, decipher, and make decisions. That's what
okay. It's all about. Yeah. Now, how many Dutertes are running right now? 5 or 6? Am I right? 5 or 6?
5 in the tally board. I don't know what the board commented. Five.
So let's put it to 5. There are 5 Dutertes running right now, and I think it's only you and your sister, Migs Nograles, running for the first district. She's running against Paolo Duterte. It's the first time they're running against each other too.
Yes. Actually, truth be told, it must my sister was the first actually to make a decision. She was the one who first decided that she wanted to run for first district. It, for me, longer process for me.
Oo, mas mahaba sa'yo. So ang tanong, halimbawa, nanalo ka. You know, it happens. You know, David and Goliath is the famous story. David beat Goliath. Kaya mo bang makatrabaho si Baste Duterte? I mean, yes, I know you have your candidate. You already have a vice mayor, right? You have to forgive me. Can you mention your vice mayor right now, sir?
Vice mayor who's running independent as well, Bernie Alag. Mm-mm. Bernie Alag, is a councilor of the first district and he's also running vice mayor. Yes.
Okay, and malakas na konsehal to, no? Ito yung malakas na konsehal sa inyo. Oo. So halimbawa hindi siya pala rin, nanalo ka, si Baste Duterte nanalo. What will that be like? Can you work with him?
Like I said, no, I'm running independent. And I welcome anyone and everyone who is going to come and help in their own small way. And I will take that even when, if I'm blessed enough to sit, it will still be the same attitude. I will reach out. I mean, the counselors, the strong counselors might not be, you know, independents as well. They have their own party. They have their own local party. So it will be about really convincing them also, no? It kumbaga yung pagko-convince mo for a chance, for change, for the changes that you want to implement, for the improvements that you want to implement for the city. At the end of the day, palagay ko naman, if it's for the benefit of Davao, it's for the benefit of the people of Davao, they will all support. I mean, how could you say no to Davao and improvements for the city of Davao? Hindi ka naman makakahindi. I mean, if you're a true public servant, if you're really there for the people, if talagang you have no agendas or yung agenda mo really is to serve, then I think we could win them over.
Yeah.
So you cannot say no to Davao, right? You cannot say no to the people of Davao.
Well, you do have candidates, underdogs that have beaten strong personalities and political dynasties. Si Isko Moreno, naging mayor ng Manila, tinalo si Erap. Huwag natin kalimutan. And there are other stories in Pampanga, in Isabela. Kumbaga, hindi ito nangunguna, pero natatandaan ang mga kwentong to kasi it's close to a miracle, as some would say, right? It's like, are you feeling that now? Are you feeling that?
Kaya nga election, di ba? In election, you cannot predict talaga. You can never, ever, ever, ever predict what will happen in an election. It can go this way, you think it's going that way, then it'll go the different direction. You know why? Because it's really up to the people. It's really up to the people. It's not up to the candidate, really. I mean, the candidate can only do so much. But the first thing that you really have to do is give them a choice. Because if you don't give them a choice, then it's zero chances talaga. There's zero chances for change. But you don't put yourself out there and you don't give them a choice, then there's really nothing to select. There's nothing to pick. But if you give them a choice, then maybe they might spring a surprise. Kasi at the end of the day, nasa kamay talaga ng mga kababayan natin. Nasa kamay ng botante. That's what elections are all about, diba? Nasa kamay ninyo. So you can never say ganito, ganyan. Never predict an election, because really it's up to the people. That's why we have elections. It's up to them.
Okay. So huli na to, no? Anong uri ng panunungkulan ba ang maaasahan ng mga Davaoenyo? What kind of leadership can they expect if they say, I'm gonna try Karlo Nograles this time. Ito siya na boboto ko. Si Duterte noon was known from the time he took over is essentially he claims of course cleaning out Davao from communist rebels, right? Bringing Davao to modernization from the time he took over. But now the 21st century, anong uri ng panunungkulan? What's in the first 3 years? Ano ang plano mo? First 100 days, midterm? Anong maasahan ng tao?
New. It's going to be new.
Bago. Bago.
Okay. It's going to be new. Bago talaga. Kasi different eh. It's a different person. It's a different candidate. It's a different name. It's a different guy. So it's going to be new. And pag sinabi natin new, like I said, the business permits should be faster. We're going to go e-governance na, mag-online na tayo, mas mabilis. Alam mo bakit? Kailangan mas mabilis ang mga negosyo para mas maraming trabaho. Kasi maraming walang trabaho sa Davao.
Really. Maraming walang trabaho sa Davao.
Marami nangangailangan ng trabaho. Let's put it that way. Marami nangangailangan ng trabaho.
Oh, so ang tanong ko, kapag mayor ka, alas 8 ng umaga, nasa City Hall ka na.
Ay, ask CSC.
Tanong niyo, so isa ba yun sa mga issue ngayong election? Isa ba yan?
Up to the people, really. But ask CSC, flag racing, I'm there, you know.
Oh, so kapag nanalo ka, sinasabi mo, Carlo, maaga. Maaga bukas na City Hall.
Hanggang gabi, I'm there. Yes. Oh, with all the work that we need to do, yes. Ang dami kailangan gawin. Magpupuyat po tayo dyan. Work never stops. Sa CSC, work never stopped in the CSC. I'll take that discipline to City Hall. Pasensya na. Ganyan po tayo magtrabaho. And there's a lot of work that needs to be. Business permits should be faster. More benefits for our senior citizens. We will maximize the SEF funds, the special education funds. We'll build more classrooms. We'll fix the flooding problem here in Davao City. We have the funds. May local disaster risk reduction fund tayo. We have the local development fund. We will use those funds. We'll fix the flooding problem. It won't be instant. Alam niyo naman po yan. We'll have to rebuild We'll have to improve the drainage. We will ask for help wherever it can come from, whether it's national or our local development partners from JICA, wherever. There's a master plan already, 20 billion for the short term, 60 billion for the long term. For Davao City, 8 billion we have to shell out for the flooding problem as our local counterpart, another 8 billion in the long term. Samahan niyo ako, let's fix these problems together.
Okay, you've said that already, and so sinabi mo bago, one of the things former President Duterte was famous for was actually that he held meetings late at night when he was president. So, pag nag-mayor, ang tanong ko ngayon, paano mga meeting mo?
Morning, afternoon.
Umaga. So, balikan. Aga ka sa City Hall.
Opo, but believe me, with the work that needs to be done, abutin tayo ng gabi.
Uh-oh. So what is the policy of Karlo Nograles as mayor? Is it an open City Hall? Anong istilong babaguhin mo?
It's going to be open. It's for the people. City Hall is for the people. So it's open. Anyone should be able to come. Those asking for help. We'll put systems in place. It will be open to the public. But lalagyan natin ng sistema, di ba? Because I know I have to address the needs of particular needs ng ating mga kababayan who need help. For medical needs, but we'll put systems in place so that it's more efficient. I'll try my best to see everybody, to talk to everybody, but lalagyan natin ng sistema ang lahat. If I don't get to see you or talk to you, at least makakakuha ka agad ng tulong mula sa City Hall, and it will be open to all.
Oo. Matanong ko lang, Karlo, no? Takot ba ang nangingibabaw sa Davao o nangibabaw noon?
I don't know. I really don't know. But now you have a chance to change it.
All right. Anong mensahe mo kay dating Pangulong Duterte?
Mr. President, boss, andito na po tayo. Let's give Davao a choice. This is about giving Davao a choice. This is for the people of Davao.
All right. On that note, I want to thank you for joining me today, Karlo Nograles, former Chairman of the Philippine Civil Service Commission, running for the mayoralty seat in Davao City. Thank you.
Thank you, Karen.